So class 10 students, today we will be studying about reflection and diffraction of light. So we will consider first mirrors. There are two types of mirrors. One is a plane mirror. Whose reflecting surface is smooth. Okay. Spherical mirror smooth and plane. Spherical mirror whose reflecting surface is caught inward or outward. So when it is inward or outward, there will be two types of mirror. One will be called as concave mirror. Is a spherical mirror whose reflecting surface is kept inward. Like it is like this. Means this is silver coated or bronze coated. This is your reflecting surface. Okay. So now if I consider a convex mirror. Convex mirror is a spherical mirror whose reflecting surface is kept outward. Outward means it is like this. This inside it is silver coated. This is your reflecting surface. Okay, now what you'll do is, what are the laws of reflection in the spherical mirror? Laws of reflection in the spherical mirror. That is, incident ray reflected ray and normal lies on the same plane. Second point, angle of incidence I equals to angle of reflection, that is R, that is I equals to R. How to understand this? Look at the diagram here. Suppose I have taken a concave mirror. Concave mirror. This point ko there will be a normal, means this angle will be 90 degree at a point. Because this is a concave mirror. So incident ray, this is your incident ray. Incident ray, this is your reflected ray. Incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal. And the normal remain on the same plane. Then angle of incidence with normal is I, angle of reflection with this is R. These two should be equal. Now if I take a convex mirror, then I will have a surface like this. Then incident ray I, reflected ray, incident ray, reflected ray, normal at the same plane, and angle of incidence equals to angle of reflection. The rule is same. Okay, so what you do is you study some points, what is called center of curvature. Okay, look at, I'll draw a circle here. This is your center C. If I cut this part, keep here, so this will be like this. C is here. So center of curvature will be what? Or if you cut this part, if you cut this part, then it will remain like this, and center is here. Either it is concave or convex. So both will have center of curvature. Center of curvature means from here to here the distance is the radius of curvature, because this is the radius of the circle. This is radius of the circle. So this will be radius of the circle. So let's write down what is called center of curvature. That is center of the mirror that lies on the principal axis. This is called your principal axis. This is called your principal axis. So let's write down what is cone of the mirror. That is middle portion of the mirror. Suppose there is a mirror here, this middle point, these two parts should be equal. These two part. So central part, point P of the mirror is called pole of the mirror. Pole of the mirror, okay. Then comes a principal axis. The line that is perpendicular to the surface of the mirror. Principal axis. To understand this, it is a very important vector here. That to this surface, this angle is 90 degrees. So this will be your principal axis passing through center of curvature. Okay, then radius of curvature. Radius of curvature is CP. That is radius of central, radius of the spherical part. Here PC, that is PC equals to R. R will take as radius of curvature. This is R. Then what is focus? Focus, that is a point F. The middle point or midpoint of PC. That means that is PF equals to FC. If I take which is equal to F, that means this is F, this is F. So you get F2F equals to R. Or F equals to R by 2. This is very important for us. So, rest I will be teaching you in the next class.